Good afternoon, guys. It's Saturday, September 24th. My name is Dave Coker, and this is Talking About Finance. So let's dive right in and get started. I want to start to trim these down to 10 minutes. I went a little bit over last week. My apologies. It's a chill weekend in London town. And I don't mean chill as in relaxed, but chill as in it's getting cold. And we've had the heat on the past couple nights, so you got to wonder what it's going to be like in a couple of months when the cold really kicks in. And speaking of cold, my gosh, these markets, it seems as though everything is getting battered, which doesn't really make sense to me. We know investor sentiment is near record lows, but at the same time, earnings are robust. And sure, they're weakening a little bit as interest rates are increasing, but I'm not sure this market, the S&P 500, the love of our life, really deserves all the negativity being tossed at it presently. After all, if you're investing the proper way, the one and only way, the way everyone should invest, the way I know you invest, for dividends only. As share prices fall, yields rise, and you get more cash flow for your money than if stocks moved the other way. See, the only thing I can conclude is an overwhelming majority of people are messing about in this market. No, I don't call them traders because they're not. I don't call them investors because they're not. From my point of view, they're just idiots messing around, buying stuff for no good reason. They don't know what they're buying. They don't know why they're buying it. And when the price doesn't move as they expected, they sell hard in a blind panic. My God. They change an unrealized loss into a realized loss, and that's it. They're poorer for the experience. To quote Morrison from 1937, oh, the humanity. The market doesn't deserve this. So last week, the S&P 500 was down 4.65% on the week. It's now down about 22.5% year to date. An excellent op. For those of us who are well positioned, take a look at the chart, the heat map from last week, red across the board. Although Apple sort of traded sideways. You can see healthcare as a sector. Sort of traded sideways, sort of interesting that did well. Aside from that, pretty much everything, consumer defensive, seems to be doing okay. Everything, though, burned in a major, major way. The VIX traded up from 26.30 to 29.93, so we're now up one standard deviation, more than one standard deviation, above the mean. Not quite signaling distress yet, but concern. Concern for our market, concern for the S&P 500. And once again, if we see that VIX pop, you see it move to two and perhaps three standard deviations above, we could see far more downside to this market, perhaps one final blow off. Instead of this chipping away, let's just do it. Let's just burn. Let's crash the whole thing. Then we can start to rebuild and get it all out of our system. The 10-year note finished up on the week at 3.68%. It's up 0.2% year to date. Oil closed the week at 79.09, down some 7.1% week on week. It's up only about 5.2% year to date. So once again, my friends, fear is back. The retail crowd is embracing fear. They are wishing. They want to be punished. They need it. They want the losses. It's some kind of guilt thing. That's the only thing I can figure out. They need to lose money. And to think some people call me a psychopath because I never change my investing plan. I've got the capital. I invest only for dividends. That's it. I bought Bitcoin and Ripple this week. I'll be buying stocks Monday 1 week. Probably 1 week from next Monday. October the 3rd, the first business day. After all, the dividends for September will have been received. I need to put the capital to work. So I'm going to dive into the market, pile more in, and we'll see what happens. So let's get into this market and see what my crowd of 50 or so investment bankers, hedge fund types, analysts, all hanging out in the Telegram channel, have been chatting about all week. And new subscribers, welcome. We talk about what me and my buddies were chatting about last week on a Telegram channel. It's a global group. We talk about finance 24/7. And I bring the best to you. The night is young, so let's go. And we can see here, when we start to look at the market carnage, this was really funny. Somebody from Shanghai put this over, and I thought, well, my God, this is real interesting perspective. I have to admit, I tend to look at the stocks mostly. I do look at other commodities. I look at obviously, because I got a huge position in gold and silver, I look at bullion. But then she said the only thing that was up last week was orange juice. So, yeah, the safe haven last week was orange juice. What do you expect? It's really wild, these markets, really strange. And we see that investors, retail participants, I should say, are buying put options. Now, we know this has gotten sort of a hip and trendy thing to do. They don't really understand the valuation of options to begin with. When you say stochastic derivative, you know, for Black-Scholes, they look at you like you're speaking another language, and you are, because they don't know what they're doing. So I really don't put a lot of, I don't raise a lot of concern. This is retail. If you look at the institutional numbers, they're not so extreme. So yeah, retail investors buying right now, it's a buy to open, which means a new position. They're buying puts. And my gosh, they're really going for it. It's absolutely amazing. Oh yeah, and I've shared with you guys that I got the greater bulk of my money in gold and silver. This was funny. I'm getting a lot ribbed from my friends, but I don't care, right? I still got the gold and silver. And yeah, we're not up as much as we were, say, 6 weeks ago, 3 months ago. But I don't care. Because anybody could see this inflation coming. So yeah, it takes a while for gold. It takes a while for silver. It takes a while for the markets to move, to incorporate new information, to react and price things accordingly. So yeah, if you haven't got a position in bullion, it's not too late. Going through ETFs, I've got a bundle. I got the bulk of my money in ETFs because 71% of my retirement capital, you can't take physical possession. It's in an IRA, first of all, and you don't want that much gold and silver. And then I've got my walking around gold and silver, as I call it, in my pockets. I've always got gold and silver with me, about 10 ounces of silver typically, about an ounce of gold. Or I also can walk around with Bitcoin. And then I've got other gold and silver in my safe deposit box. Right, not electronic as my IRA, but locked up physical locked up in a safe deposit box up at Harrods. Two of them, actually. So yeah, I'm still holding. I'm not selling. I'm going to continue to hold because something good is going to happen with that position. Oh yeah, and something really weird is going on here. Check this out. I spoke to you guys before, and people have been listening for a long time will know that I make and sell NFTs. Market really boomed last year. It went quiet. And there's been a little nibbling, but my God, something really amazing happened on OpenSea over the past 2 weeks. Some of my stuff that never sold has been bought. Other stuff that's sold, and the value, the power of an NFT, is that artists can get royalties. And some of the stuff that I've sold, some of the NFTs that I've sold on OpenSea have sold once, twice, and one sold three times. And I pick up a little bit of money on every sale. It's really wild. So yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but again, my friends give me a hard time because they know I make and sell NFTs. And another thing that's really interesting is this Ripple. Now, I've been buying Ripple for about a year. I think I've spoken about it here before. In fact, I know I've mentioned that I bought it. And the reasons were I was paying a great deal of attention to the lawsuit, to the crypto in general. And Ripple is amazing, used by well over 400 banks globally. The US, the SEC sued it. They won't classify it as a security, even though it kind of looks like it's more a commodity like Bitcoin. And they've been fighting the lawsuit, and it looks like they're going to get the suit tossed out. It's going to go their way. It's not going to go SEC's way. So there's been huge advances in Ripple. My God, you know, I was down 71% at one point on my trade. I just kept buying every week, more at those low prices. And then it started to creep up, and then it started to move up quickly. And in one day, I woke up, I was only down about 15%, and by the time I went to bed, I was up about 22% on that position. Really, really wild. So yeah, Ripple is my risky cryptocurrency. Not to be confused with Bitcoin, which I don't think is that risky. It's more operator error and things like that. An interesting one, I can't remember who came up with this chart. It was on the tweet, and I stripped it off. My apologies, I'll dig it up later. Oh, John Hart, I'm sorry. Yeah, that's right, John Hart did it. It's his analysis. And he says that Bitcoin's been trading at a discount over the past whole year and for most of 2021 as well. Well, it doesn't change my mind at all. I still buy Bitcoin every week. I'll still buy Bitcoin next week going on. continue to buy Bitcoin. I have three Trezors now, because you don't want to put too much Bitcoin in any one single hardware wallet. So I've got three Trezors, and I'm getting a Ledger because I think it's good to diversify into different hardware wallets. Yeah, so I'll just keep buying Bitcoin. Bitcoin's actually very fascinating that way. It's really good currency, really good crypto, I should say, to buy and hodl. Hold on for dear life. And this is pretty much my experience with Bitcoin. I've been active in the market pretty much, I won't say exactly where, but definitely close to the left-hand axis. And guys, you buy and you hold. You buy and you hold. These selling points, I don't get. I don't like them. I'm not doing it. I think it's all done in retrospect, and it's bullshit, by the way. You want to convince me that you know what's going to happen to this crypto, this market. In fact, any market, publish it in advance. Don't publish it later and go, yeah, I knew when to sell. I told you when to sell. And if you sign up for my course, I'll show you. No, it's garbage. So I don't appreciate the sell signals, but I do like the message of the buy and hodl. Hold on for dear life. Okay, guys, we just got in. We had dinner, the pub, drinks. We're heading out again, clubbing. You know what it's like. The night is young. It's only about 7 o'clock here. Got to do a little at-home drinking, then we're moving. My poor wife, I drag her about. Yeah, clubbing tonight. I wanted to go up to Tate Modern to see some art today, but turned out we've been up there so much, we've seen all the art. Yeah, so we're waiting for the Cezanne show to open up in about 2 weeks, and then we'll head up for that. So have an excellent week, guys. Put some capital to work. Put it in the market and forget about it. Put it in the market, forget about it, and get rich slowly. It's the only way to be sure. Take care, guys.